Applying to the Small Business Innovation Research, SBIR, Small Business Technology Transfer, STTR, program at the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities.
Hello, I'm here to talk to you about the goals of the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities, NIMHD, Small Business and Innovation Research and Small Business Technology Transfer Program. By the end of this video, you will have learned more about the goals of this program, NIH-designated health disparity populations, and what areas you might want to focus on in your SBIR or STTR application.
What are the goals of the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities, NIMHD's Small Business Innovation Research and Small Business Technology Transfer, SBIR-STTR program?
The National Institute of Health's Small Business Innovation Research and Small Business Technology Transfer, SBIR-STTR program, is one of the largest early-stage life science investment programs in the country, and it is open to a wide variety of applicants. Through the program, the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities, or NIMHD, is able to provide grant funding for small businesses working on commercial efforts designed to achieve health equity for specific NIH-designated populations. NIMHD's SBIR-STTR program funds mostly FDA Class 2 and Class 3 medical devices, digital health interventions that are community-based and problem-driven, and interventions that promote health education and or disease prevention. The interventions must focus on achieving health equity in NIH-defined health disparities populations, which we'll define a bit later. NIMHD's SBIR-STTR program has four main goals. First, to promote research that helps us understand and improve the health of racial and ethnic minority populations. Second, to advance our scientific understanding of the causes of various health disparities. Third, to develop and test interventions to reduce those health disparities. And finally, to create and improve scientific methods, metrics, measures, and tools that support health disparities research.
What is a health disparity, and what are the NIH-designated health disparity populations?
A health disparity is defined as a health difference that adversely affects disadvantaged populations in comparison to a reference population based on one or more health outcomes. All populations with health disparities are socially disadvantaged because they've likely been subject to racist or discriminatory acts and because they are often underserved in healthcare. NIMHD focuses on 9 NIH-designated health disparity populations: American Indians and Alaska Natives, Asian Americans, Blacks and African Americans, Hispanics and Latinos, Native Hawaiians and other Pacific Islanders, people with disabilities, sexual and gender minorities, socioeconomically disadvantaged populations, and underserved rural populations. There are many factors that can contribute to health disparities, including the built and natural environments people live in, experiencing structural racism and discrimination at an individual or community level, having limited access to economic resources or experiencing food insecurity, having limited access to health coverage or other healthcare infrastructure, and needing to engage with healthcare and or research that is not culturally competent or that lacks understanding. Considering how your innovation will possibly address one or more of these factors and or other social determinants of health is critical when preparing an SBIR-STTR application. Your application should be responsive to the Notice of Funding Award and NIMHD strategic objectives when describing how your intervention would help alleviate physical barriers, knowledge barriers, infrastructure barriers, economic barriers, or cultural barriers. Within NIMHD, we use a research framework that outlines several additional factors relevant to understanding and promoting minority health and reducing health disparities. The goal of this framework is to encourage research that spans different domains of influence, which you can see on the left side of this chart, as well as different levels of influence, which you can see running along the top of the chart. Each of the cells include different factors that might influence individual health outcomes, family or organizational health outcomes, community health outcomes, and population health outcomes. Using this framework can also help you align your research questions with NIMHD's focus areas and keep your proposed concept within scope. As an example, perhaps company X wants to use machine learning to create focused guidance to help individuals control their diabetes. They also want their intervention to be both culturally competent and easy to access for the identified population. If company X wants to focus on individual behaviors, they might design an intervention that focuses on specific behaviors that could help individuals track, manage, or cope with their symptoms. However, if company X instead wants to focus on interpersonal influences within the healthcare system, they might design their intervention to focus on strengthening the patient-clinician relationship or empowering patients to make more informed decisions about their treatment options.
What areas should I focus on when developing my NIMHD, SBIR, or STTR application?
The first thing you'll want to focus on is something I like to call your concept equation, which should be conveyed within the first few sentences of your application. Developing this early on is incredibly important for writing your research questions and maintaining focus in your research abstract, and it will also help the reviewer quickly focus on the problem you identify and your proposed intervention. Start with your identified health disparity population. As an example, you might choose to look at Hispanic or Latino men in the United States. Selecting a specific population doesn't mean your intervention couldn't help other populations, but the reviewers want to see that you've been thoughtful in trying to address a problem for a specific market. Next, describe the problem you've identified. In this case, you might choose to address high rates of high blood pressure in that specific population. Then you'll discuss your intervention and why it's an improvement over any of the current interventions on the market. Maybe you believe that a lack of culturally competent and accessible preventative care is the biggest barrier for this population as they try to manage their hypertension. And you're proposing to use mobile units staffed by specially trained, multilingual clinicians to improve access to care. Lastly, be sure to discuss how your intervention would improve health equity for that specific population. This first part of your application is where you'll discuss the how and the what of your intervention. So you want to ensure the reviewers understand your research question, the population and problem you'll be targeting, and the basics of your proposed intervention. This grant is an investment by NIMHD to support and further the Institute's objectives. So you also want to continually re-emphasize how your intervention would create, support, or improve health equity. It's also critical to ensure your application is responsive to the funding notice you're applying for. I've seen applications disqualified numerous times because they propose an intervention that is not within the scope of the funding opportunity, and the review board finds them to be non-responsive. The funding notice will also have information on the specific interest of the Institute, so please also keep those in mind while you're preparing your application. For example, if NIMHD is looking for digital clinical services and your application focuses on a non-digital method of alleviating patient food insecurity, that intervention will be found to be non-responsive to the funding notice, regardless of whether or not the reviewers feel the intervention is a good one. You'll also want to ensure your application includes a hypothesis and preliminary outcome data on how your intervention will improve health equity in your specific market and/or with your identified population. This hypothesis should be informed by any preliminary data you've already gathered. There should also be some discussion of how you'll continue to capture data from your identified population and how that data will contribute to a strong commercialization plan for a phase two application. In addition, you'll need to talk about why your product or approach is an improvement over other interventions that are currently on the market. Talk about why your competitors aren't delivering this kind of intervention and how your approach would improve health equity for your chosen population. How will your intervention better serve this population? Will it make existing processes more efficient? Will it better meet your population's needs in some way? And if so, how? You want to make your case to reviewers that your proposed intervention will be a meaningful improvement over existing options. The highest scoring applications always use their aims pages to discuss how they're going to actually implement the strategy they're proposing. So make sure that you are clearly tying your research aims to practical actions. For example, maybe one of your aims is to develop a prototype for an online professional development course to train clinicians in more culturally competent ways to address hypertension in Latino men. You might include specific objectives, such as recruiting Latino men, for focus groups to inform the development of the prototype, developing the prototype, pilot testing the prototype with both Latino men and clinicians, and iterating on the prototype based on feedback from those populations. Those are specific, actionable steps you'll take to demonstrate your proof of concept, which is a critical part of this application. Lastly, watch for common traps and make sure you're addressing potential concerns reviewers might have, such as how you would handle HIPAA and any privacy concerns, navigate institutional review boards, design clinical trials, and ensure you have people with the right kinds of expertise on your team and in your biographical sketches. Applicants must take into consideration that reviewers will be reading 50 or more applications and will experience fatigue. Make sure from the beginning that there's no doubt about what your research question is, what intervention you're proposing, and which health disparity population or populations you are targeting with your concept. Checking these boxes will go a long way toward ensuring you'll have a quality application. But it's also important to tell a story about why you're applying for a specific opportunity. Whether it's because you're a parent who struggled with a lack of cultural competency in previous interactions with your child's pediatrician, or you've experienced food insecurity that has led to a worsening of a chronic illness. This is the only time you'll be talking to the reviewers, and it is critical that you be able to convey why you're passionate about your intervention. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video and learn more about developing a strong SBIR/STTR application for the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities. If you have additional questions, please visit our website at www.nimhd.nih.gov.